Hello everyone. Before we begin, let me introduce myself. Briefly, I'm Wali Alami Shaima, PhD student at Sidi Muhammad bin Abdullah University. The purpose of my presentation is to present view Bald Modern Behavior Specification based on UML concepts. First of all, I would like to introduce this topic and explain the problem. And then I will present the precedent when we talk about view-based UML approach, and we will explain the concepts of our approach. We will continue by implementation of our approach using an example. And to finish, I will conclude my presentation. Let's go to introduction. The speed evolution of this design technique in the field of software engineering, the construction of complex computer system remain a very difficult task. In this context, it's often impossible to construct global model that take all needs into account as one. In reality, the application is broken down into several partial models that reduce the size and complexity of the system. However, a computation phase must be initiated to obtain the final version of the application. Our objective is to address the problem of the behavioral model, the treatment amount, to train in the following two crucial points. The first one is the specification of the behavior of object's view for each actor, and in the other hand, the composition of this behavior to form the global behavior of multi-view objects. To solve this problem, we propose reuse the mechanism for specifying behaviors and communication between UML objects as is. So we described an approach that involves using standard UML mechanism to specify the behavior of the UML view objects and communication between views. So what is the UML or view-based UML? It is UML profile based on the pound of view modeling approach explicitly rely on the UML standard, and her objective is to introduce a set of concepts and mechanisms to manage access right to view to multi-view classes and specialize to multi-view class, specify the dependency between views, ensure consistency of the model in case of updates, and administer view at runtime. The VUML approach consists of three main development phases: a centralized phase of requirement modeling, and the decentralized phase of system modeling according to each point of view using different UML diagrams, and finally centralized phase of fusion and modeling producing the VUML class diagram. That's the concept of VUML. And now I will present the concept of our approach. There are three steps. The first one, global behavior analysis. The main role of this phase is the identification of the machine base of multi-view objects. It consists of extracting the most relevant state from the multi-view objects. We obtain the machine base in the form of an abstract skeleton that describes expected behavior of the multi-view object as a whole. Second, behavior analysis designed by point of view. For each actor, we make a mono-view analysis of the machine base states already developed in the first phase. We develop states of intercept for the relevant actor. At the end of this state, we get the machine view of all the actors. And finally, the behavior fusion or synchronization. The role of this phase is to make the behavior consistent by making the correspondence between the machine view and the machine path. And now I will more explain this by an example. This is the general use case for our example. repair agency manager. There are many cases and many actors, but we will concentrate on car management as case, and as actor, we choose client and agency manager. First of all, identification of reactive multi-view classes. We consider for the sake of simplicity that only the car class has reactive behavior. The other classes are considered to be data classes or statistic. And after that, identification of the potential states for each reactive multi-view classes. For our example, we synthesize these states as follow. Out of orders, initial condition, this is initial condition of the car. In garage routine, the condition that represents the step to bring the car back from where it's broken down to the garage. In expertise procedure, state representing the operation of expertise on the car to detect the fault. And in repair procedure, after fault detection, the car began in the repair procedure, which consists of two essential parts. First one, the negotiation of the repair contract based on the result of the expert assessment, and the technical repair representing the action of repairing the fault detected in the assessment phase. In test, final step before leaving the garage to test the proper functioning of the car, and excite state representing the end of the life cycle of the car in the garage. We will have concentrated in repair procedure of client and agency manager. The transition in the state machine client car viewport from the expertise procedure state to the repair procedure state is triggered by request repair signal from the client actor. And the viewpoint of the agency manager, the same principle on the centralization of communication in the machine base is applied. The state machine agency manager car, when it receives the request signal repair from the machine base, return into the agency manager actor, then he prepare form containing a list of the failure to be repaired, as well as the choice that's accompany the repair for each failure. Once the form is ready, the agency manager send into the state machine agency manager car, and in the final steps, behavior fusion in the machine view of the car associated with the client's point of view, the signal repair required was sent to the machine base, because the developer developer from the client's point of view did not know how was going to process this signal. This the agency manager machine view waits for this signal to pass through to an expertise procedure state to a repair procedure state. The first synchronization message is shown in the following figure is for this correspondence. The synchronization work is continued by following the same process until the final machine is produced. This approach responds to the problem in the following way: to promote an independent development in the second phase of the approach. However, with this approach based on UML concept, when scaling shows limitations concerning the behavior specification, we have difficulties in ensuring independence in the development of youth, as they can be strongly intertwined. And concerning the composition of the behavior, the integration of the separately developed view machines might require many modification and adaptation at the level of the view machine and the base machine. And thank you for your attention.